Welcome back to Let's Play Skyward Sword. We're starting off in the sky today because I just wanted to save a little bit of time. Anyways, in the last episode, we got the second part of the Song of the Hero, and now, in this episode, we're going to be working towards the third and final part of the song. We're going to head over to Lineru because, well, that's where it is. And yeah, for once, the game doesn't hold your hand and tell you where to go at all. Like, it just kind of tells you, in this general area. So yeah, the game is just like, could be anywhere over here. So we're gonna go to West Desert because that's the closest possible place that we can warp to that that anything's really going on. It's actually pretty close to where we have to go, so it's really convenient that there is a warp point right here. And we're gonna go up here, and we've been here before, so if we pull out the claw shots, we can go up there. We're gonna go on to the tallest rock because, you know, easier to reach things that way. Yeah, we've been up here before, and remember there's a Goron, and we did some stuff, but now there's some new stuff in this cave, and man, they really don't tell you what to do. So if you got stuck here for a little bit, I would totally understand, because knowing to go into this cave and then talk to this guy, it's definitely not cryptic. I wouldn't go that far, but it's easily missed, I guess you could say. And we're gonna go over and talk to him, and he just kind of forcibly talks to you. He's like, nice to see you, Link. Say, you ever find the sacred flame you were looking for? Really? You did? Great. Dots? See, so after all that adventuring, you finally found it. I have to say, you're pretty amazing. Why, yes I am. I have a sort of legendariness. Found out some more about the legend of the three dragons. News is gonna blow your mind. Found out that there is indeed a hidden area beyond here. There is a narrow path I cannot fit through without losing a few pounds. I think you have to lose more than, just a few pounds. But yeah, the Thunder Dragon is in fact somewhere behind that wall. And all we have to do is blow it open because Zelda, that's why. Zelda games, you always have to just, like, you know, blow holes in walls and... What? What? Huh? Did the Goron, like, deflect that or something? Sorry, Goron. I'll just do this. There's also a stool here. Don't worry. There's another stool up ahead in case you want to recover your health. You're going to want to be at full health, everybody, because we have a little section coming up here. Also in this small area, there's nothing there. There's some butterflies. You can probably play the harp and get, like, fairies if you know what you're doing, but in general, there's nothing in that room. I checked very thoroughly. All right, Fee, what's going on? This is the Narrow Gorge, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, so they stop holding your hand and telling you where to go and what to do. And then they're like, but now that you're here, let's give you a little tour. Now, if you look off into the background, you'll notice there's a cube, the last one in the entire game. Signs in Kate, ancient civilization established, quarry here. Yeah, so they're talking about the minecarts. We've dealt with the minecarts before that have the time stones on them. And that's going to be the main mechanic going on in this episode. And we've got another little part of the map revealed. We're working towards that full map revealing. And you really, trust me, you do not need this map. Because this whole area is super linear. So first we're going to start off by activating this. We're going to do that so we can warp back here anytime we want. Also, there's a stool over there, in case you want to use it, which you should if you don't have maximum hearts like me. Not that I'm special for having maximum hearts, but you know what I mean. We're just gonna do that, and as you can see, there's a locked door. Why would they put a locked door, like, outside and not, like, in a dungeon? I have no idea, but the key is really easy to get because we just have to go over here, pull out the beetle, and we're just gonna grab the key that's just right here. Thankfully, it's sparkling, so it's not, like, too hard to find. And I don't really know why they decided to just be like, hey, grab this key that's right here to open this door that's right here. I'm not really sure, but hey, it's a thing they did. So let's go ahead and here, and now we shall begin the minecart trial of doom. Now, this might give you some trouble because there's a ton of enemies and a time limit because the minecart is always moving. So we're just going to use some claw shot action, and a bug. Bye, bug. Let's go ahead and activate this with the annoying stabbing motion, which I hate doing. You know, I have like this microphone is always like a little bit in the way of doing these motion controls because it's so big, you know? But whatever. Enough complaining. I'm gonna talk to Wolverine over here. Lots of big time shift stones. Did you get permission from the Thunder Dragon? Let's pretend I did, because I'm the chosen one, so I can do whatever. I got the Master Sword. I can do pretty much everything. There's so many monsters. Alright. I got it. Don't worry. We'll take care of all the monsters. Yeah, we're just gonna go and step on this button. We're gonna be pressing lots and lots of buttons in this episode. Hopefully, we'll get this all done, within like 10 to 20 minutes, because I don't want this episode to be super long. It might be a super long episode. Who knows? Alright, we got another one of these guys. Yeah, we're gonna be fighting lots of enemies, pressing lots of buttons, doing lots of claw shots. Ugh, I almost got that, but not quite. Get rid of that guy. Yeah, most of these guys you don't actually have to fight. I accidentally ran into that one, but whatever. I gotta ignore that one. This guy we actually have to fight. And one of the annoying parts about this area is sometimes the door will close behind the minecart and you'll be stuck and you'll have to like pretty much kill yourself. So I don't really like that. I'm gonna use a spin attack here because it's super easy to just spin attack and then just take care of them, you know? And I remember what to do here. Gotta wait till everything spawns though. That's almost like an interesting way of like hiding loading times. Just be like, time hasn't switched yet. That's why there's nothing on screen. I don't know. Maybe that's not the case, but I don't know. It is an interesting thing in terms of programming, I guess. All right, gonna do more claw shot action. There's really not much else to explain in this episode. We could probably just like talk about whatever. Let's talk about music, because I never talk about music, do I? I always just talk about games. Let's talk about video game music. That way it's still mostly on topic, because I like video game soundtracks, because they've changed from, you know, just beeps and boops to actual music. Who's question of the day? Who's your favorite video game composer? I accidentally hit that stamina. Okay, that's fine. That's totally fine. Who's your favorite video game composer? Mine is Yuki Kajiura. You probably never heard of her, but she did the soundtrack for Xenosaga and also Sword Art Online. And who doesn't like Sword Art Online? Most people, actually. But it doesn't change the fact that the soundtrack is pretty awesome. I actually also recently imported Link. He's not moving. Oh, okay. I don't know what happened there. He literally just wasn't moving. I was like pressing things and nothing was happening. That was really weird. Yeah, I got the soundtrack for Sword Art Online. Has some really nice music in it, I must say. And I don't know. I don't think I've listened to the whole thing yet, because it's 130 tracks, which is a lot, and they're usually a couple minutes long, so got my money's worth out of that. It was like $40 to import from Japan. So yeah, it's like less than 50 cents a song. It's a good deal. It's a good deal. I also imported let me just list off the soundtracks I've imported. Not to like show off or anything, because it's really not that much. Let me see, there's also Xenoblade X, the soundtrack, The World Ends With You, the soundtrack, and then this weird, you guys probably, like, I'll be highly surprised if there's even one person who knows what this is, but there's, like, a Xenosaga, like, visual novel type game on the PlayStation 2, and I have the soundtrack for that. I almost didn't want to pick up the jelly blob, whatever. You're wasting time! You're wasting time, game! Why you do this? But yeah, it's kind of a weird thing, and I don't know much about it because it's only in Japanese, but I bought the game and the soundtrack. I haven't opened the soundtrack. It's probably super rare, so I don't want to touch it. Let's just put away this whip. Here we're gonna have some spike things to dodge. Just dodge it nicely. We still have max health, which I'm a little surprised about. I don't know about you. If I can just... No. Excuse me, sir. I'm trying to avoid you. Man, that was cutting it close. We got an ancient flower here. Sweet. Not that we probably need it, but maybe it'll be helpful. I don't know. Doesn't hurt to pick up like one extra one of these. All right. There we go. All right, so now we got like a million of these spiky things to dodge. I didn't dodge that one, or that one. All right, this is just going perfectly. Yeah, I don't think the minecart is slowed down by these, or at least I hope not. Just gonna dodge, and the most annoying room of this section is coming up soon. Also, yes, I know we kind of got off the topic of soundtracks, but I think that's all the soundtracks I've imported. All good soundtracks. All good music. Good music all the time. Video games. Alright, so we have to wait till time moves. And we can do this. Make sure you grab every stamina fruit, because you're going to need it. And we're just going to pull this lever. And you have to run, because otherwise you're not going to make it. And get rid of these guys. Excuse me, guys. Nope. I'm just... Fine, I'll just ignore you. In fact, the best strategy here is to ignore pretty much everything, because you don't have time to fight everything, especially that guy up there, which we're going to completely ignore, because we don't... I didn't even equip my shield. That might be useful. Wow, I'm taking a lot of damage. See what I mean? If you're not, like, prepared, you might die here. Alright, stab motion, which I somehow pulled off. Easily. Get rid of that guy. Get rid of you. Man, there's so much junk going on the screen right now. I'm gonna cut you down to size. And then cut you down to size. Yeah, thanks for shooting me anyway, guy I just cut down to size. I didn't feel like doing the double stab motion. Haha, you can't reach me, you're not tall enough. Alright, so for this part... Get ready. You have to run for that door. I'm not joking. This door will close right behind you. Nope. 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 Oh. Oh, so close. The door. Man. I don't know why they do that. That door closes behind you so fast. It's not even funny. I missed it earlier and I was really upset. Alright. We're already getting most of our hearts back. We didn't take too much damage, but still. Getting close to that part. There we go. So we're going to use the beetle, the tough beetle, as I think it's called when you upgrade it. And we're just going to go and blow up some rocks. Alright, there we go. I don't know why I stopped talking there for like 5 seconds. That was probably super unprofessional of me or something. I don't know. Am I even a professional Let's Player? Tell me, if you have a ton of experience doing something, and you're pretty much a pro at it, but you don't really make much money, can you still be considered a pro? Who knows? Maybe you knows. And that's pretty much it. That was the minecart section. I think the last minecart section in the entire game. Wait, except for... I think they have a minecart in the final dungeon? I'm not sure. Anyways, We're almost to the Thunder Dragon, but not quite. We still have more stuff we have to do before we can get the song. So it's just gonna go here and then power up. Come on, do the power up. It shrinks, and then it grows, for some reason. And you can see the bones of the Thunder Dragon just coming back to life. Except not really, because time travel. And so that's going to be it for this episode. Thank you all for watching. And next time, we're going to be talking to the Thunder Dragon and seeing what we have to do to get the next piece of the song and then complete it. And then we'll be happy. But we'll do that next time. And also get the final Goddess Cube in the last episode. Or next episode. Whatever. See you guys then.